Hey everyone, it's Kaylee and welcome back to another video. So in today's video, I got ready for absolutely nothing, by the way. I just completely got ready. I curled my hair some more and then I did a full face of makeup, as you can see. I literally just got done filming a Get Unready With Me, which you guys will see tomorrow. But I had a full face of makeup on, more than this. I did lashes, I did all that stuff. And then I got completely unready. I took off my makeup, winded down, looked all busted and everything. So I just decided after that, I was like, you know what? I don't wanna go to bed yet. So I got up and then I put on a full face of makeup again. I got ready in a hotel. I'm in LA, baby. And yeah, so if you guys would like to see how I got ready for today, then just keep on watching. So first I'm going to start off by putting my hair back, because if you guys know me, I hate having hair in my face when I'm doing my makeup or my hair down. It's just, it's the biggest pet peeve of mine. Like when someone's getting ready, like I literally physically cannot. So I'm just taking these like little hair clips things, the creaseless hair clips from Amazon, and just put my hair behind my ear and then like really like pull it back so it's like they're tight. This one did not get tight, so it's like up there and stayed there tight. Okay, my hair is kind of being a little weird today, but we'll just deal with that. So after I'm done doing my hair, I'm going to start on my face makeup. So what I use for my face makeup is, well, I'll start off by the primer. So I use the Milk Hydro Grip Primer. I love this primer, it really does work. This is like the only primer that I really, you know, figured out that works, because it's like tacky and everything, so your makeup just completely stays and sets on your face like all day. And then since I do use a stick foundation, I use the Hourglass foundation, I do take some face oil. This is by Truly Beauty. It's Blueberry Kush face oil. And I just take about 4 drops of the oil, not too much because I don't want my face to be too oily. And then I'll just rub that in like that and then just press that all over my face. So the stick foundation really does glide on nice and easy. So for foundation, I'm using the Hourglass stick foundation in the shade Bisque, and I'm just putting this all over my face. I know it might look like a lot, and it probably is a lot, but this much works for me. And yeah. So I use that for my foundation. And then my brush, I like to use a brush for my stick foundation because the Beauty Blender, I feel like it like picks up the product a lot and just does not blend out good. So I'm using just this Shop Miss A brush. It's a high def brush. It's in the style F4. And I just kind of tap that, not really much dragging. Sometimes I'll drag just to like really finish the product, but most of the time I will just tap the product on, and it just really, you know, it doesn't pull my makeup, it doesn't pull my face, so it won't get streaky. But yeah, like look how full coverage the foundation is. I love it. It is obviously more pricier than a drugstore foundation, but it does work. You just gotta get the hang of it. Since it is a stick foundation, stick foundations are obviously different than regular liquid foundations. I know the first time when I tried this, I did not like it because it made my face really dry. At least I thought it did. But then when I really started using it, I ended up really liking it. So you just really gotta use oil or like any thing to like help with the base of your makeup, because obviously if you don't have a good base, you're not gonna have a good rest of your face. Yeah, so I'm just blending this in. Sorry if the lighting's a little bit like bright or like a little bit off. Obviously I'm in the hotel, and if you guys know, hotel bathroom lighting sometimes they will be good. Like this time, like when I look in the mirror right now, like it looks good, everything looks fine and everything, but then when I pull up my phone or like right here on the shadow, like it just, sometimes it just does not pull through. You know what, it is what it is, but. And then after that, I'm going to be using my e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer and just concealing my face. And then I will use the same brush and blend it all out together. And then obviously I'm going to set my makeup. So I use the Kodi Airspun Loose Face Powder. And then I just take a brush and then just use the, just tap it in here and literally just swipe this all over my face. Like I use it. If you guys can see, I got powder all over me, all over my black clothes. So like I was saying, I just take the brush and the powder and just dab that all over my face. I do things way differently now since I use a, sorry that it's so like far away. Since I use a stick foundation. Then after I set my face, I take my Fenty Beauty Bronzer in the shade Shady Biz. And I use the same exact brush that I use to set my face. And then I just literally dip it in this because why not? And then I just tap it. I don't do this. I just tap it so it's really focused on the area that I want it to be focused on. And it doesn't make it harsh or anything. It just makes it all nice and blended. But I'm going to take the bronzer again, and then I'm going to use this more like contoured brush, as you can see, like a little eyeshadow brush kind of, but it has a slight angle to it. Dip into the bronzer and do my nose contour. I didn't do crazy nose contour because I don't really need to contour my nose. I just kind of, you know, put it there and then see how it goes. And then I'll take the brush, dip a little bit into powder, and just like tap it off, and then just go over my nose so it's not like too harsh. And then take my NARS blush and give myself some rosy cheeks. And then the holy grail of the products of this whole makeup look that just really ties everything together is this Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder. It's in the shade Radiant Light. And then I take a Sephora Pro Angled Brush and just literally tap onto it and focus it mostly on my cheek area where I would put my highlight, because I don't use highlight anymore. The only time I use highlight is in the inner corner of my eye. And I just, you know, put this all over my face. It doesn't really do that much, but it really, like, you can tell that like something is going on that with your makeup, like in a good way. Like it's like, I don't know, it just really blurs everything and just like makes, I don't know, it's just something about it. You guys just really need to like get it to try it to know what I'm talking about. But I love this stuff. It is more expensive, like how the foundation brush is, I mean the foundation stick is, but it's worth your money, trust me. And then after I finish with my face makeup, I just move on to my eyebrows. So I'm just taking the e.l.f. Precise Eyebrow Pencil and just fill in my So those are my brows done, and as you can see, they are a lot darker. So what I do, especially since I just got my hair done and none of my roots are showing, so it doesn't even seem like I have like brown hair, I take the same brush that I used for my powder and I dip into the powder and tap off pretty much a lot, but still have product on to where that I can set my eyebrows, but like, you know, make them lighter. So this is a trick if you do like see the difference, like it really does, you know, tone down the brows a lot. and still make it like look natural, but like still make it like it'll look like you have it. So that's what I really love about doing that, and just really tones down the thing so it just like all blends in. Next, I am taking the NYX Professional Jumbo Eye Pencil in the shade 601 Black Bean and put it under it on my waterline. This is what I do every single day. So it just looks like that. I really love doing this because of my green eyes. So I love having that little trick to do. And then I'm going to be putting on mascara. So the two mascaras I'm using is the Morphe mascara. I love this one. It's literally just like the Better Than Sex, but for so much cheaper. Like Better Than Sex is probably like $22 or $26. This one's $8, dude. $8. Love it. And it's literally the same packaging and everything. It looks exactly the same. So I'm just going to start off by putting the Morphe one on first, and then I use the L'Oreal Telescopic mascara. I was going to put on lashes, but I put on lashes earlier today, like for literally the whole day, and I just took them off because I filmed a Get Unready With Me. So these were them. I took them off because I just didn't want lashes on anymore, and plus they're a pain in the butt. Well, not really a pain in the butt to put on. I know how to put them on like really quick, but like to take them off, you know, the glue. When you guys watch that video, if you guys do, my eyes watered so freaking much because the glue was like, you know, sometimes it gets stuck, it's whatever, like on your lashes and everything. So it hurts really freaking bad to take it off. So I would put lashes on, but I don't want to be in pain and I don't want to rip off my eyelashes. So I'm taking the telescopic one and going over the top, and then just using this for the bottom. I finished off my mascara, just looks like that. And I'm not gonna put on any lipstick because I'm just gonna take off my makeup anyways right now. But I am gonna be putting on the Laneige lip mask. Freaking love this lip mask. It's amazing if you have chapped lips, which I mean I don't, but like look. Like it really, love this lip mask. Like even you can just like put on so much at night and then you wake up and your lips feel like a baby's bottom. It literally feels so nice because of how smooth it is. So now that I'm done with my makeup, I'm going to go over my hair because as you can see, some pieces that got flat, and I have to wake up at 4 a.m. tomorrow, so I'm not gonna go over my hair then. So I'm just going to go over my hair and make sure everything is nice. So if you guys are wondering what curler I use, it's just the Foxy Bay curler. I love this wand so freaking much. Then also comes with a little glove. I use the glove because I really get up in there, so I don't want my hands to, you know, burn off. I just went over some pieces. I'm not going to brush through them because I'm just going to leave them nice and bouncy so I can just brush them out in the morning and they'll be nice and wavy. I didn't curl all of them, just pretty much the front pieces of my hair, like right here and everything. So yeah, that's how it looks. I'm not even gonna change clothes because I'm not going anywhere other than downstairs later on to get makeup wipes. But this is what I'm wearing. It's cute anyways, just a simple outfit. Just the light in here, no ma'am. So just this crop top, black crop top from Urban Outfitters, and then some biker shorts from Pretty Little Thing. Super cute, I love it. And yeah. So this is it for a get ready with me in the hotel. I really hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Make sure to like, comment, share, subscribe, and turn on those post notifications so you can get notified every single time I upload a new video. And stay tuned for all of these videos that I'm gonna be uploading. I'm gonna be uploading a crap ton of videos. So make sure you turn on those post notifications because you guys do not wanna miss out. And yeah, I will see you guys all in my next video. Bye.